Hi, I'm Taylor Robertson, and I'm a professional boxer, and you're watching Uncharted Waters. So I'm here at World Gym Maroochydore today, and I'm here with Jackson Johnson. He is a bodybuilder, and now he's an ex-bodybuilder, and now he's working to help transform other people in coaching and transforming their own bodies and making it themselves. So basically today he's going to put me through a bodybuilding session. Now if I'm going to do it, I'm going to jump in with the best. So he's been to top three in the world, the WBF. Like three times.
Yeah,
he's been like over 10 comps, competed in America. Yeah, now he's helping everyone else's journey.
Jackson Johnson here. So as Taylor said, ex-bodybuilder, competed in a few competitions. Now I'm helping other people transform their body. Today's gonna be good. We're gonna be going through a pretty brutal full body bodybuilding session, and we're gonna chuck in some posing training because as much as Tay is an amazing boxer, getting her outside her comfort zone is today's goal, and I think doing some bodybuilding posing is going to push you out of your comfort zone. As much as you're confident with the gloves on, this is a different thing, and it really pushes people to, you know, think outside the box, and it's going to be really fun.
See this?
Yeah, girl.
Warm our shoulders up and just start getting our hand speed going, get a bit of a rhythm and flow on the back, and then we're going to go from there into some technique, and then we're going to start getting the technique and footwork down pat, and then from there we're going to break into some hard rounds of pad work, put the pressure on and see where his boxing fitness is at. Footwork and be able to punch on the go. So if you're under high intensity pressure, you need to be able to have the energy to plant your feet and land your punches. So there's all different types of boxing. You need to be good at all of it. So this round's punching off the back foot. So you're transferring the weight and the power. So here. Yeah. So here. No, sorry. Just go lean. Here.
Oh, okay.
See how I'm almost getting lateral again?
Yeah.
And then I'm pulling in.
So I've been doing my
right. Here. Or body, head. Body, head. And then when we do hooks, same thing. Turn up with one of the neck. This should be solid. This should be like a steel bar.
Your rotation.
Yeah, and the rotation whips it into your opponent. It should never be dragged across from the shoulder.
No,
like
it's through the core.
Yeah. Which is probably where bodybuilding would actually have a good effect on that. Good stuff. awesome.
That was amazing. Probably one of the best boxing sessions I've ever done. We're going to do some bodybuilding training now, which is going to get Tay out of our comfort zone, and I get to be the coach, which I'm very excited about. That's my job. I want your quads and your glutes, everything together, really. Your calves, we're not going to worry about too much. Your boxer, you skip. You've got really conditioned calves, so I'd be here for an hour trying to change your calves. So we're going to work on quads, hamstrings, glutes. We're going to do some body weight stuff, pull-ups, which I'll assist you with, and just simple stuff like push-ups. Like, you should be able to do a lot of them because of boxing, but we're going to do push-ups where we're using more of the chest instead of the shoulders and triceps what you're used to. So to start with, I'm going to show you how to act, which is a common problem, but your glutes look like very active. So my hips are only moving like a centimeter.
Yep.
All we want is pretty much no movement.
Okay.
So, good, perfect. Don't do it fast. Slow, slow, slow. Stay low. So it's like a gymnastics movement. That's it. So those muscles are pushing out. There we go. Now tap.
That's it. That should perfect way right there.
Nine. Chest up. There we go. Good stuff, Tay. Awesome. Excellent. This range here, like you were, you're gonna actually drop your shoulder blades down, come all the way until your chest goes underneath where you would on a push up, and then you're gonna squeeze your chest, come to there.
Yep.
Excellent. Good. One more. Up. Gonna look at your lunge and your leg strength. And we're gonna use these kettlebells to start with. And I want you to actually do some walking lunges. And then after you do some walking lunges, I'm gonna get you into a stationary lunge. We're gonna do all different types of lunges. This is gonna bring a little bit of burning on this, but it's safe. I've got pretty much no weight going through your spine. I don't wanna hurt you. I don't wanna be the person that takes Taylor out of her sport. So I'm being very safe. As you step, pause, come down through the back leg. Use your glute to come up. You have a little touch there, pause. Believe that you need to use big weight to train, even to do bodybuilding style training. Eventually, by doing them properly,
you can go into the muscle up.
Properly.
Shit.
So that's because I got really good at doing full range dips and full range chest, and making sure that my pull-ups are like chest to bar every one.
Okay. Got this.
Yeah, and hands should be like right where you are. Yeah.
Okay. Good. So jump. Yep.
Hold at the top, okay. Elbows in.
My legs are still jelly, okay.
That's right, it's all your arms. Come down slow. All the way, all the way. Elbows in, jump. That's perfect.
Good stuff.
There's no more. Then we're gonna go into the gym, and we're gonna go in front of the mirrors, and then we can do a little bit of posing too.
Okay. That was really hard, actually. I think actually slowing it down, because in boxing things can be quite fast all the time. Something's always happening. You're always on the go, ready to react. Whereas here, I have to like really slow everything down, focus on the muscles, get the technique down pat.
Slow. Not a lot of weight, but you won't need a lot of weight. Good. Slow. Three more. Two more. Slow. Good. Not too high. We want to take the traps out of it. We're trying to work these little shoulders here. That's better. Feel the difference?
Yeah.
Good. chucked out of it.
You've got
That's better.
See? So this is like the competition stuff for you on
the
stage?
The first one you want to learn doing is kind of like the leg poses. They're probably the most important. That's the ones that took me ages to learn. So if you pull your leggings up a little bit. So obviously, guys obviously have less body fat in here.
Yeah.
And also, the more muscle you have, the easier it is to see. But what we want to learn on doing, usually you have one leg that's your better leg. So pull the other one up as well. So usually like right leg, you put that slightly further forward like this. And you keep, it's a weird thing to learn.
Yeah.
You kind of bend the knees, that flexes the muscles.
Where's my muscles at?
Yeah, that's all right. Yours is not going to look like this. Yeah. Most girls don't. And then if I move across a little bit like this, and then you bring the elbows up in line with the body like that.
Like this?
And so I know that this is more comfortable, but if you like, and as you do that, you actually pull your elbows and your lats out like this. So you drop them down and pull the elbows like that. See how it flares you more?
Oh,
see the lats now?
Yeah.
So it's like pulling out, squeezing here, and then you bend the legs a little bit. And then I really like to open the ribcage up, which is good like that. That's perfect, look at that. And if you keep holding that, it's very fatiguing.
Yeah, it is. I just want to see some muscles in the legs.
Keep pulling the elbows out. Good. Good, good. Another way to do it is to point your leg down like this.
I can think about everything at the same time.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, and then another pose. This is more like, a lot of female poses aren't going to be like this. And if you, let's say you weren't doing boxing and you wanted to do a bikini pose,
yeah.
The bikini poses would be more like glutes and other poses.
Yeah.
You wouldn't do this, but I'm taking you through traditional bodybuilding.
Yeah.
And there is still females that do more traditional bodybuilding.
Yeah.
So let's have a look at the back poses now.
Yeah.
So we'll have to face this way.
You need these rolled up still?
They can be stay right there, that's good.
Okay. So
it's the same thing, same thing as before. You come down and you squeeze your back together. Now you can kind of like bring one foot back if you watch me and get that calf going a little bit. Good like that. That's it. Yeah. And then the same thing as you squeeze, then you're going to pull the elbows apart like this and you're going to tilt. That's good. Good. So if you get a shot from the back here, this is probably like one of your better poses because you've got such a defined back from people just genetically have better muscle groups. And you can see the lats are really flaring here, everything's in a good position. And as you can tell, it's pretty fatiguing.
Yeah.
Like you're shaking a little bit, which is good. And then the more you arch the back, the more you have the roundness of the glutes as well, which is good. Alright. That feels full on.
Yeah.
Now let's do some tricep stuff, because I know that was something you showed earlier. With this, to make your hamstrings look bigger, it's all an illusion. Basically, because if my hamstring's like this, it doesn't look amazing, but you actually squish your leg in like this, into the side, and then you grab the wrist and you turn back like this. But basically, an easier way to show it is like, basically, you're like this, so you're like leaning and showing your abs and stuff, and pushing your body in like that. So legs the same as this. So push that leg into that leg. Good, bend a bit more. Eating. If you don't practice it when you're really fatigued, you don't know what it's gonna be like on stage. Because when you jump on stage, you've had a little bit of caffeine, you've kind of depleted yourself for 4 or 5 weeks, then you add in some carbohydrates, so you got all the feathering for everything. And then you gotta learn how to like open everything up and flare it all. And if you don't practice it, just like, if you don't spar, you don't know what it's like getting hit. And it's like that with posing.
That is so much harder, and there's so much dedication to it. It's like boxing, you have to dedicate yourself to it. It's like, it's not just something, they've got good genetics, they're gonna kill, they've got it easy. No way. That was so hard. If they've got to do this every day, it's respect to them.
Tay is just an incredible athlete, but putting her outside her comfort zone pushed her a lot, and this is gonna just help her with her sport. Like, for me to get good at, you know, bodybuilding and other things that I'm involved in, like calisthenics, it was me getting on a surfboard for the first time after growing up in a country town that made me better at my other sports. And it makes you just more humble knowing that just because you're really good at one sport doesn't mean it's going to transfer over. And there's also skills you can pick up in all different walks of life. So yeah, it was awesome.
Yeah.